ComNote is a pre-existing application for an Android device. It was developed out of the Digital World Research Center. And initially, it was designed for use in the developing world, which has not a strong broadband type infrastructure, but they do use mobile technology an awful lot. They use a lot of mobile phone technology. So it's a very simple to use device. And I'll just give you a very quick demo of exactly what it does. Now, that's not what it's all about. What you basically have is a device for creating slideshows on the fly. So you have an image, a caption, as you can see there, and then if you want, and you usually do want, a piece of audio of some kind. Now, for me, this is very useful because I'm a composer, so my research, which is led very much by my composition, is into aspects of creativity, particularly collaboration between composers and performers. And those of you that have done any form of this research will know that it tends to produce an enormous amount of documentation. It's easy to take some kind of recording device, turn it on, and have 3 hours of continuously recorded audio, which you then have to sift through. Now, ComPhone doesn't really allow you to do that because it works in a slightly different way. What you basically do, if I give you a quick, another quick demo. If I take this one slide here, you can see the three elements that you've got. The picture, the audio that always goes with that picture, and then the caption that you can put on the bottom. So in other words, what you're doing is you're chunking up the audio via these photos or images that you're using, which means that you can't really just go on and on and on. If you did, you'd have one image sitting there for 3 hours. Okay, so I can insert any kind of sound into this frame. So to show you how easy it is to do, I'm going to just insert a little mixtape of a little bit of my music so you can hear some of the stuff that I do. Okay, so if I now just... This connection's a bit weird with the thing on the camera, so that's why it's... My music's a bit more eventful than that, I must say. Okay. Okay, so it's a good device for recording and keeping track of process. It can also be used, though, for collaborating between musicians because you can make your own narrative. So a musician that I'm working with could receive music from me and could make a narrative for me and then present it back to me. I could view it, you can upload them to YouTube easily, make comments, and so on and so forth. So the project that I'm working on with this phone at the moment is exactly to do with this. I'm looking at how composers and performers collaborate, and particularly I'm looking at the fact, the way that performers respond to certain types of notation. All those pieces I played you, there were three different pieces, they all sound quite different, but what they have in common is they're all quite strictly notated within the limits of Western notation. The piece that I'm currently working on with the Liget Quartet, who should be on here actually, let me see if I can get my phone working a bit better. Hang on. So, okay, so if I just go back. Okay, so the Liget Quartet and Simon Desbruslais are working on a piece that's far more loosely notated. So they have a lot more creative decisions to make. And what I'm interested in researching is how they respond to having that increased responsibility, if you want to put it like that. So what they have is their own comm phones, and they will be recording the rehearsals, making narratives of the rehearsals, which I will then be able to look at. They can upload them to YouTube and so on, and I can see how they are negotiating this kind of element of the piece. Now, what's useful about that is that it means I don't have to be there breathing down their necks all the time. So it gives performers a little bit more freedom to experiment, to try out new things without me physically being there, and I can come and look at the material at a later stage. So there are basically two ways that we can use this. I can record my process of composition, and I can also then collaborate with a performer who's made a narrative, and we can feed back to each other like that. Let me just quickly find one slide which just demonstrates me feeding back to a performer on something that they've done. So,
hi there, Simon. It's the 27th of May today, and just thought I might give you a bit of feedback on the 9 long notes practice that you sent me, as you can see in the picture. It's very interesting, as I've put in another slide, hearing something that's so abstract for me. I mean, clearly, without the quartet, it sounds like nothing in particular.
Now, there's quite a lot more, but that's the kind of thing that me and Simon have started to do. So Simon will make his own narratives for me, responding to things that I've given him and so on and so forth. There are ways that we need to make this more efficient, and we're the only people to have run out of time, but I'm just going to, if you can let me take one more minute to hand over to Janko, who's going to tell you how we might develop this to be a little bit more efficient in terms of sharing it.
Yes. So at the moment, we've just started the project and we are doing a couple of user studies in during the rehearsals of the quartet and with Simon together with or without the composer, and see what are the problems in terms of the interaction between this system and in both kind of scenarios where composer leads or the performance lead. So at the moment, we have outlined a couple of existential problems, I would say, when it comes to the sharing between the content, and we are developing now the application to the next level, starting off with the existing application and bringing it to the level where it's going to be more usable for exchange of compositions. In addition to that, we'll be studying different, natural user interactions with the device that will help composers, such as tapping, beat making, gestures with the mobile phone through different sensors that are available on the phone, or laying out the frames or the content that exists there in kind of more structured form, so that it's not a one-dimensional thing. And I think I didn't go over a minute. Thank you very much.